We are back. You roast tomatoes, you get tomato choker. From tomato choker, you can get tomato choker soup with rice. Apparently, that's one of Chris's favorites. It's on his website, CaribbeanPod.com.
That is correct.
Chris is going to give us the link, and you can check it out on TriniCooks.com as well. But Chris is going to show us how easy it is to put together this little delicacy. It's a light, refreshing, tasty soup.
And there is rice in it.
So you get some carbs as well?
We were always looking for that rice.
You get some carbs.
No, we replace the ground provision that we would normally put in our typical soup.
Right.
Put in the rice in there, and again, it's light. It can be vegan, it can be vegetarian, or in our case, we'll be using chicken stock.
Right.
Just to get that extra flavor in
but
there.
But you can't use vegetable stock if you're adverse to chicken stock. Yeah. Could you throw a pigtail in there?
Most definitely.
That would be my ridiculous
mind. Yeah, yeah.
My healthy folk in the back. You throw a pigtail in there. No?
You know, the funny thing is, if I were making this for my dad,
yeah,
pigtail, salt beef, or he wouldn't even ask me any salt fish. He will go with a spoon moving around. I don't see anything in there.
Salt fish.
There you go.
You put salt fish in there. That
you
takes
know,
it
back
up
in the old days, they would roast the salt fish. For that extra flavor. Well, I don't know if it's flavor or what, but they would roast it. So maybe that would add a nice depth of flavor in there as well.
Let's do the basic one today. Yeah. We're going wild in terms of our imagination.
It's funny how when like-minded people get together, how they come up with ideas just by talking.
Just old talk. So what are we doing first? We're going to... You have roasted. You did this whole hocus.
This one, for convenience sake, we did these tomatoes in the oven.
Right.
A high oven, you sort of toss them in some olive oil. High oven, maybe about 15, 20 minutes, and then they break down and you get this lovely sort of caramelization happening for the sweetness of the tomato. Mm-hmm. Typically, when you're making a tomato choker, it would fire roast it. My grandmother had I can't remember the name of it, the clay thing with the coals and the clay, a coal pot.
A coal pot, yeah.
Okay, she would do hers on a coal pot.
Right.
Today, what we're going to do, I'm going to show you guys how to do it indoor. We're just going to fire roast
on
it
an open flame.
Now, in my case here, I'm using a metal fork.
Right.
Just be aware that it may heat up in the process,
right,
so you may
want
to hold it with a glove or something.
Right.
Or you can put some tin foil and roast them on there as well.
Right.
All we would do is leave it on here. We just want to char them to bring out that sweetness from the tomato.
Yeah.
And again, that sort of charring also gives you some flavor later on.
Depth of flavor.
As we would see when... from the oven as well, that sort of charred skin is part of it, right?
Mm-hmm. You don't want to throw away that at all. That's the flavor there.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's the flavor there.
Yeah. So all we're doing is sort of charring it. Now, the other element to a good tomato choker is the pepper element, the heat element. And in our case today, we use, it wouldn't have as much heat, but we're using
pimento
pepper. Typically, you would use a scotch bonnet pepper or
they
call a Congo pepper or something.
The real heat is.
To bring out more of that heat and that niceness of the pepper, my grandmother or my mom would typically roast it as well.
Right.
I'm holding off on that today. We're kind of controlling the heat. We want to make it easy for everyone to eat. You know, from small down there to up here, everybody eating without complaining about the pepper.
So
as you can see, we're getting that lovely char marks and stuff like that. That is what we want. Once it's charred and we flip it all over, then we would get to actually putting it together. Now, in a typical tomato soup, tomato choker, it would be the garlic, the onion, the pepper, the salt, and stuff like that added during the whole thing. And then you would, what we'd call chunky at the end with the heated oil.
Yeah.
We're going in reverse now. We're going to start with that heated oil in the pan. So this is basically what we're looking for. So maybe we can move the pan over now.
So it's almost like a deconstructed tomato
we're
choker.
Them deconstructed today.
Deconstructed tomato choker to get the soup.
Maybe we could turn the heat down just a little bit because we're starting with that garlic and onion and we don't want to burn it.
Right.
But you get a pan. So after you roasted them, you allow them to cool.
Right.
And then you would go in with some good olive oil.
Nice.
If you have coconut oil, I mean, do your thing.
Yes.
Show off if you want to show off.
Yes.
We have olive oil today. So all we would do is heat up that pan there with the olive oil. And right away, we would go in with some diced onion. And this is where we're kind of deconstructing because we would end it if we were making the typical tomato choker.
Mm-hmm.
So we would go in with that.
Starting with that.
We're starting with the onions. And the whole idea is to do it gently so we get...
That's about a half a cup?
Yeah, just
about half a cup. My friends out there, I follow recipes, Chris. So the way I cook, I need to say, okay, half a cup, 3/4. That's how I cook.
99% of the people coming to my website, that is exactly why they come. Because they're getting it organized in a manner that's easy to follow, right?
Here,
40 measures, 3 cloves of garlic, large cloves of garlic that I sort of diced up. If you want to crush it, do your thing, nobody ain't trying to hit. So we got that going on a low flame there, and you just want to sort of sweat that down to bring everything together. At the same time, I've got that diced pimento pepper. Now, if you had the fire roasted scotch bonnet, you would also add it in here. Now, be mindful with the scotch bonnet. The closer to the seeds, the sort of white membrane around the seeds, that's where most of the heat is. The seeds, again, most of the heat is going to be there. So if you're trying to cut back to get some of the flavor and not so much of the heat, avoid those areas.
Avoid the
seeds. And we can't say enough about washing your hands with soap and water.
After. I have that experience already. I learned that the hard way.
You know, the funny thing is,
I learned that the hard way.
Just about every recipe I use, there's a heat element to it that I do. And I always tell people that. Who get catch? Mm-hmm. You tend to tell people, and then you tend to forget as well, right? Your own self.
But
all we're trying to do now is to get that going, to get a nice little sizzle going, and you allow that to go for about 3 or 4 minutes, just to bring out the sweetness from the onion and the garlic and stuff like that, right?
So tell me about the rice. Why rice in here does what to the soup?
You know, the typical tomato soup in North America is tomato and liquid. I wanted that sort of body to it. I grew up in the Caribbean where we would have ground provision or dumpling or something, a sort of a starch or a carb in there. So I thought by adding the rice in there would give me, you know, according to my dad, when there isn't something like something heavy in there, he called it belly wash, not soup. You know, so we go somewhere and we get broth or something. He's like, but this belly wash.
It's not soup.
It's just to rinse out the inside, you know what
you
I mean?
You Caribbean people. I mean.
So I thought by adding the rice in there.
It gives a little body.
Body, you know what I mean?
Yeah, nice.
The only thing about adding the rice is that the longer it stays in the liquid, the more pronounced and big the grains get. So just be mindful of that. That if you're serving it, I would cook it maybe half an hour prior to anything before that, and it tends to take up a lot. It sucks in a lot of the liquid.
Right. So you want to add the rice last.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just before.
And the rice, typically we use in a long grain brown parboiled rice here, so it probably take about 15 to 20 minutes or something.
Right. So while this is doing its thing here, what Chris and I will do. We both brought out a cookbook in recent times, so we're going to exchange the cookbooks now. Chris did his cookbook, and of course, for those of you following the show would have known that we launched our cookbook last year. Probably it was just after this time, around this time. It was to celebrate our 200th episode back then. Mm-hmm. And we launched our cookbook, and we've been following CaribbeanPod.com for so many years that it served as an inspiration when we did TriniCooks.com, that somebody out there was also very interested in collating and putting together our recipes. Chris was doing that, and TriniCooks.com started doing that 10 years ago. And Chris also did his cookbook. Tell me a little bit about the book.
The book, maybe 2.5 years ago,
right.
We ran out of stock. So it's been out of stock for the past couple of years. We have new stock coming in mid-July, and that will, again, be available on CaribbeanPod.com, Amazon.com, Amazon.ca. And we're hoping for Amazon.UK.
Right.
And we're working on that in the back kind of thing. But
so the concept is just all your favorites?
It's 100, right? 100 of the most requests. I pay a lot of attention to what people are asking for and stuff like that. So I thought by putting it in the book, it would help it become a bestseller. And selling 5,000 copies in 3 months wasn't bad.
That wasn't bad at all.
So,
it wasn't bad at all. So,
but Joel, there you go.
Thank you very much.
And I will go home and play around with this a little bit.
Very well, very well.
So, if you see your recipes end up on my website.
And vice versa.
Yeah.
And vice versa.
Let's just hope there's no copyright infringement.
TriniCooks.com, CaribbeanPod.com, all one and same, the recipes.
Yeah.
So this is happening here nicely.
Yeah, you know, and we got the garlic going a little bit golden.
Hearing the sizzle now.
Yeah, and you're hearing the sizzle. You can smell that as well, too.
Yeah.
And the beauty about using that pimento pepper is that you're getting the flavor off scotch bonnet pepper without that raw punch of heat, right?
Yeah.
I typically call it Caribbean sunshine, and people have started using the word Caribbean sunshine now when they refer to scotch bonnet peppers.
Right.
You know?
It gives you that boost of
there you go, Caribbean sunshine.
Heat. Yes.
Yeah. So we have that there now, and what we're going to go in now is and typically I would crush these before, but you can crush it in there.
In there as well.
I know back in the old days, the mortar and pestle, they would crush it.
Right.
And you want to try and leave as much of that skin and stuff like that, because that, again, the flavor is in there.
And release the juices in there as well.
Yeah. So we would do here is go in with the roasted tomatoes into the pot. And I'm going to use this wooden spatula here just to crush it. That's because we want to release all the the flesh of the tomato in there. Mm-hmm. And it kind of reminds me, I remember growing up, there was a lady living across the street, and she would wake up 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning when I would be getting up and getting ready to go to school, because I lived in the countryside in Guaracara, but I went to school in San Fernando, so we had to wake up early.
Right.
But every morning, and you ask my dad, he would say the same thing, she was always pounding. We had no idea what this woman, every day, pounding, and it must have been garlic. She would use in all of her dishes, but I remember the whole pounding thing.
Did you ever find out what she was pounding? We just hope it's garlic.
We hope so. we'll leave it at that, right?
We hope it's garlic. Look how that came together nicely.
Nice. Yeah, you know, and it's almost the base of a pasta sauce as well, if you look at it.
Correct,
you know what I mean?
Correct.
A simple tomato sauce.
Yeah, toss that in some pasta and you have a wonderful little...
Yeah, definitely.
So you season up salt and pepper?
No salt. I'm not going with salt because I'm using purchased chicken stock.
Right.
And that usually have a sodium element to it. So later on, you can taste it at the end if you want to add some more salt. And I've been trying to cut back on the amount of salt that I use as well, right? But I will go in with some black pepper in there.
Nice. Chef Bianca, who is coming up a little later on the show, she's doing an eating green segment. She'll be glad that we're not using salt.
Oh, there you go. But she may have a problem with us using chicken stock.
Yeah. All right, don't tell her everything.
I mean insecurity to leave. So we got that nice and coming together here. We got a thickness happening. So the other two ingredients, and it's very basic. You notice just tomato, garlic, onion, oil.
Yeah.
Usually you have that in your pantry in any event, right?
Simple.
So we've got the rice coming, and we've also got the chicken stock here, right?
So you're ready for the chicken stock?
Yeah, definitely.
So we're just adding the chicken stock straight in there.
Yeah, I'm just going to back out just a little bit in case it jumps back.
I've got it.
There you go. That should be enough.
And
we're just going to give that a quick stir.
Wow, simple as that. You could add a little cream to this as well. Chef Bianca won't listen to this, but you could add a little cream to this as well.
I would go with coconut milk.
Coconut milk.
Keep it natural.
Nah,
keep it,
nice.
Keep it close to home kind of thing. You know what I mean? Go in with the coconut milk, and it would also add that lovely sort of coconut flavor in there as well.
So if we
started with the coconut oil, I like building on the same sort of ingredients as well.
Like.
And this is about half a cup of that rice that we talked about. It's been washed.
Right.
I usually, you know, the funny thing is you look at... North American TV.
Yeah.
And two things people, as Caribbean people, we have problem with is when they say season and they go in with salt and pepper and not seasoning, and when they don't wash rice. So the rice has been washed.
Has been washed.
Mm-hmm. You can probably scoop that in there.
Yeah. And you allow this to do its thing for about?
I would say about 15, 20 minutes.
20 minutes.
The rice will become nice and plump. The soup will thicken. So keep that in mind as well.
Mm-hmm.
If your kids like a lot of broth, add a bit more of the chicken stock and start. Because later on, once you start moving around the rice, the starch is going to thicken things up. So it looks a bit, as we would say, the thing looking watery. But it will thicken up, I guarantee you that. What I usually go in here with as well, too, and I forgot to bring it this morning, is some chopped parsley. Any sort of herbs that you like, if you like a little bit of thyme in there, you can certainly do that as well.
Nice. You know, this is the part of the show that I like the most.
Mm-hmm.
When I get to sample, I mean, this just looks...
And you notice how it thickened up. You got pieces of tomato in there.
Yeah.
The rice is nice and plump. And people who like wet pilau, the wet pilau community could probably appreciate this.
Yeah. We don't have wet pilau people here.
I'm a dry pilau
person
myself.
You're a dry pilau man, yeah. So let's go in for it.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. So tomato soup has grown on me over the years.
Mm-hmm.
I did not like tomato soup. I just found it was too tangy, but it has grown on me over the years. This, however, guys, because I think of the tomato choker effect.
Yeah.
Has that little spiciness somehow still up? I mean, you didn't use scotch bonnet. Did you use scotch bonnet there?
No, this was just pimento pepper.
But there's a nice little spiciness to it, nice little kick. The tomato is not too tangy. It has a nice little sweet edge to it.
Mm-hmm. And you mentioned about the pigtail, and we talked about the sorbet, and we talked about the salt fish.
Mm-hmm.
Shrimp. You toss some shrimp in there as well near the end, and there's a seafood element, almost like a bisque without the whole cream element to it, right? Joel?
Such a pleasure having you this morning.
Mm-hmm.
Get this recipe, guys, CaribbeanPod.com or check TriniCooks.com. A simple tomato choker rice soup. Fantastic. Chris Delarosa dropping by this morning. Such a pleasure having you here, my brother.
Pleasure being here.
Yeah. Look out to doing some stuff in the future as we probably chart different part of the world together.
Agree. And yeah? We have so much to offer to the world that I think it's only natural that we sort of collaborate and do things. I mean, yeah. What do you do complement what I do, so why not?
Yeah, yeah. Look out for it, guys. CaribbeanPot.com. Chris De La Rosa dropping by this morning on a Foodie Friday. Much more to come, so do stay with us. Foodie Fridays here on A Cup of Joe continues right after this.